What do you miss about FTN?
What happened to FTN?
What do you guys miss about FTN?
What happened to FTN?
What do you miss about FTN?
Good morning, Frenchtown.
Frenchtown News with David Taves and Evan Ellington here.
All right, Frenchtown, it's been a while since we've seen you, but we'd like to let you know that we are back and better than ever, now starting with some past events. Winter seasons have wrapped up, wrestling in State and Miles City, with Landon Stewart coming home as your state champion. Congrats to Landon. Girls and boys basketball unfortunately lost in their divisional tournaments and were not able to advance to the state tournament. But we'd like to recognize Brandon Findley and his All-State and MVP selection, as well as Demi Smith for her All-State selection. And finally, Speech and Debate placed fourth at their state tournament, with Isabel Pollock coming home as our Lincoln Douglas state champion.
Hey Frenchtown, it's Evan Ellington here, and here's some upcoming events. Softball's home games on Thursday against Hamilton and Saturday against Florence. JV also has a away game against Sentinel on Monday. Moving on, track and field has a meet this Friday at home. Finally, prom is this Saturday, grand march is at 8, and the dance begins at 9, and ends at midnight. And remember, prom is in the school gym.
Hi, I'm Grace, and it's time for Frenchtown Club updates. To start off, NHS and HOSA just concluded their hygiene drive, and they picked up their items last Friday. Coming up, Student Council has big plans for our Spring Fling Week, which will be April 26th through the 30th. And throughout that week, we'll have multiple activities that you know and love, like your dress-up days, activities during lunch, and even a few after school and night activities that we will be having to help raise money for Mr. Pinsnow. So on that Monday, we will have our Manpuff tournament, Manpuff Monday, if you will. So juniors and seniors, make sure that you sign up if you're a coach or a player and grab a participation form, parent permission slip to participate, or else you cannot play at all. And make sure you sign up in the office. We will have a small fee of just about a few dollars for each team to help support Mr. Pinsnow. And for Thursday, we will be having a mini parade in Honk for Frenchtown style, where we will have a car decorating contest. And we will have the opportunity to decorate those cars on that Thursday during the early out after your various sports practices. And of course, leading up to that weekend, we'll be in the Frenchtown Invitational, so come out and support your softball team, and we'll have a great Spring Fling Week. Thanks.
What's going on, Frenchtown? Caden Hansen here, reporting from the softball fields, and welcome to this week's edition of Sports Analysis. The weather may not act like it, but spring is indeed here, along with a new set of exciting sports that Frenchtown continues to heavily compete in. Luckily, COVID-19's current impact leads us to, well, a brighter and more existent future than last year. Our athletes have been waiting all year for this moment, so other teams must stay vigilant. The girls' softball season began with a challenging opponent who left them 0-1 at home. However, this loss appeared to have no effect on the team, especially after last weekend when they unsurprisingly sent both Ronan and Steve I bus drivers back to warm the buses before their teams had even played a full game. These two wins add on to a 3-game winning streak, which will unquestionably grow throughout the season. Congratulations to Coach Field on his 3-1 record, and please feel free to raise my pre-calculus grade. The Frenchtown track and field team has quite literally came out of the blocks fast and furious this year. The team is extending its ability to place all across the board. In the first three meets, the team has already won one and came at a very close second place in two others. The team aims to win this next meet in Frenchtown on Friday. Before I end, I'd like to remind everyone to please reach out to our team if you would like to see anything on FTN. This alternative suits our team much better than having been told what we should have done than having been told what we should do. Thanks for tuning in to this week's edition of Sports Analysis, and I can't wait to see you next time.
Hi, Mr. Youngberg.
What's up?
What do you miss about FTN?
I miss the witty banter between the people on FTN.
That's a great answer, because we're lots of fun around here. We love to spread the energy around Frenchtown.
Perfect.
Yeah.
All right, thanks.
So guys, how's it going?
Good.
Doing well.
What do you guys miss about FTN?
What's FTN?
Frenchtown News.
Oh! Yeah, you know, I just miss seeing all the students' smiling faces and the energy that you guys bring and keeping us updated on the happenings of the school.
Thank you.
What did you say it was again?
Frenchtown News.
Yeah,
FTN.
I guess I miss everything about it because, I'm just kidding. As a sports guy, I especially like the sports updates and spotlighting some of the athletes and things like that. But then it's also nice to see some of the other stuff that's going on in school as well.
Yes, sir. All right, guys.
You know, the other thing I think has been really cool is you guys interviewing some of the new teachers and staff, and so the whole school gets to know them. Maybe kids don't have them in their class, but it gets everybody gets to know them that way. So that was a cool feature that you guys did a while back.
All right, sweet. Thanks for the input, guys.
You bet.
Have a good one. Hi, Ms. Peterson. How's it going?
Good. How are you?
Great. What do you miss about FTN?
I think probably the biggest thing is just being able to see a different side of students and staff. Because when we're in the classroom, students are usually taking notes, paying attention. It's generally teacher-centered. But with the news, that gives us as teachers an opportunity to see the students really bring other talents that they have into the school atmosphere, which I think for all of us is great. In addition, I think the same would apply to the teachers as well.
That's a great answer. Love it. Thank you.
Thank you.